Now, some House lawmakers are seeking a probe into the recent killing of activists Zara, Alvarez, and Randall Echanis, their deaths just days apart after being described by the Makabayan bloc as a threat to all human rights workers. Now, joining us on the line for more on this is Bayan Muna Party List Representative Carlos Zarate. Good afternoon, sir, and thanks for joining us today.
Good afternoon, Stanley, and good afternoon to our viewers.
All right, first off, what loose ends are you seeing in the Zara, Alvarez, and Randall Echanis cases that warrant a House probe?
Yes, Stanley, no? We filed this House Resolution Number 1145 to look deeply into the killings. No, we don't think that these killings are just random killings. No, these are, I think, planned assassination of human rights workers, peace consultants of the National Democratic Front. No, and previously, prior to the assassination or the killing of these two individuals, the recent ones are Randall Echanis and Zara Alvarez. They have been subject, Stanley, of vilification campaign, terrorist tagging. In fact, both of them were also part of that 2018 list submitted by the DOJ, no, before a local court in that proscription case of the Communist Party of the Philippines. Although that list was ultimately withdrawn, but we saw a pattern that several of those in that list were either arrested by trumped-up charges or have been assassinated, no? Including, for example, in 2019, another one, Randy Malayao, who is also a consultant of the peace process and the regional coordinator of our party, the Bayan Muna Party List. Mm-hmm. No? So these are not just isolated killings, I think, Stanley. No, there is a pattern, and we hope that the leadership of the House will take on this investigation. We have filed several of these resolutions in the House, actually.
All right. Congressman Zarate, on the side of the groups where Alvarez and Echanis actually belong, there is strong insinuation that somehow state forces have something to do with their murders. Now, who from the government side will you be inviting to the hearing to shed light more on this?
Yes, Stanley. No? Imagine these killings happened in time of this grave crisis, this pandemic, where the state security forces are even, there are checkpoints, they are very strict. No, but how come that these killings happen? No, in the case of Randall Echanis, for example, no, there was even an attempt by the local PNP to confuse the public, at least, no, and to mislead the conduct of the investigation. Despite there was already a positive identification from the family, they snatched, no, they took the cadaver of Mr. Echanis and said that he was not Mr. Echanis, no. And in the case of Zara Alvarez, she has been the subject of several red tagging, terrorist tagging by local state security forces. No, mm-hmm. her picture and name was in fact included in several tarpaulins, propaganda materials, where she was tagged as a terrorist. No, so again, Stanley, we think that this is now the effect of this red tagging vilification campaign. No, you are not only charged with the trumped-up charges, but worse, you will be killed. No, you will be assassinated and silenced for good.
All right. Opening the probe into the killings will happen, as you mentioned, while the country is grappling with a pandemic. Now, are you confident that this kind of undertaking will get prioritized, if not for scheduling at the House of Representatives, even for the resource persons? Do you expect that you will be getting the kind of people that you want to interview or to shed light on these issues?
Yes, we hope that the leadership will also give priority to this, no? Because one killing is one killing too many, no? Especially these persons, no? They are not, they are not doing or advocating for the good of our people just because they want to, do this on the side, no? But these are people whose advocacy are for the good of our constituencies, so good of our people. For example, Mr. Echanis is an advocate for agrarian reform, Zara Alvarez is a health worker. At the same time, she was very active in ecumenical movement and Negros. No, mm-hmm. So if the House, for example, spent time and resources conducting probe on graft and corruption, the more that I think that the House will also spend some time, no, on issues like this where lives of our people are at stake, Stanley.
All right, on that note, thanks a lot, Congressman Carlos Zarate, for shedding light on this issue. We do hope to hear more from you on the developments here.